getting into the spirit of things. Life, death, and anime in between is a fine motto in theory, but in practice it can be difficult to gauge if a given series is going to take you to heaven or trap you in purgatory. Let cruising the Crunchy catalog be your helpful medium here. Each week we provide additional info and cultural context for a title in Crunchyroll's library to help anime fans decide whether or not they'd like to try out an unknown show. What's Rikan? Rikan is a 2015 TV anime with direction by Masashi Kudo and animation by Piero. The series is based on the manga by Hinako Sita, which is serialized in Hubunshi's manga Time Jumbo Seinen Manga Magazine. Crunchyroll describes the story of Rikan as follows: a heartwarming horror comedy centering around the life of Hibiki Amami, a girl who can see ghosts and otherworldly things, as well as talk to animals. Despite its somewhat ghoulish premise, Rikan leans more heavily on the comedy side of things than on the horror side. The series follows Hibiki Amami, an ordinary high school girl who possesses the ability to see and interact with ghosts, much to the consternation of her skeptical and phasmophobic friend, Narumi Inoue, who is driven to distraction by all of the poltergeist phenomena that follows in Hibiki's wake. Sweet, sentimental, and sometimes serious, Rikan maintains a light tone throughout, primarily because Hibiki is such a gentle-hearted person and because her extraordinary psychic abilities aren't treated as something that cause her distress. Despite the ghosts that constantly demand her attention, Hibiki treats everyone that she meets, both living and undead, with effortless kindness. She's a beacon of positivity. However, because the concepts of death, the afterlife, and spirits with unfinished business are central to the narrative, Rikan also has its share of somber moments. The series deals directly with themes of memory and grief, and more than a few episodes descend into a drama of a tragic nature if the story calls for it. Rikan evokes both laughter and tears. Tsundere Yuri. Another aspect of Rikan that viewers might find appealing is the Yuri content. Although not overtly a romantic comedy, Rikan hints at an attraction between Hibiki and Narumi that blossoms as time goes on. It's fairly chaste material, constrained mostly to blushing, subtext, and some intimate hand-holding, but there's definitely romantic tension between the lead characters, and that tension is tweaked further by Narumi's subtle personality. Bad Kitty. Most of the comedy in Rikan stems from overreaction, slapstick, and absurdity, and the humor sticks the landing more often than not. The only recurring joke that stumbles is the neighborhood cat with whom Hibiki can communicate. For reasons that are never explained, presumably for the sake of comedy, this fiendish feline is a source of sexual harassment. It's always trying to peek at people's panties and making suggestive comments. If that sort of comedy makes you uncomfortable, viewer discretion is advised. Ain't afraid of no ghosts. Crunchyroll currently streams Rikan in the United States, Canada, Puerto Rico, the U.S. Virgin Islands, American Samoa, Guam, the Northern Mariana Islands, and the United States minor outlying islands. The series is available in the original Japanese language with English subtitles. Sentai Filmworks also releases Rikan on Blu-ray and DVD in North America. Upbeat but also bittersweet, sentimental without being maudlin, Rikan is a good fit for people who crave light entertainment with a high concept edge. If you're in the mood for a series that explores the idea of a sixth sense as a natural extension of a person's empathy, and if you've also got a taste for screwball supernatural shenanigans, please consider giving Rikan a try. Special thanks go to resident ghost Wrangler Rosa for suggesting the subject for this week's Cruising the Crunchy catalog. Is there a series in Crunchyroll's catalog that you think needs some more love and attention? Please send in your suggestions via email to emailprotected or post a tweet to @goobazilla. Your pick could inspire the next installment of Cruising the Crunchy catalog. Paul Chapman is the host of the Greatest Movie Ever podcast and GME. Anime Fun Time.